الحمد لله الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونؤمن به ونتوكل عليه ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلله فلا هادي له ونشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له ونشهد أن سيدنا ونبينا ومولانا محمدا عبده ورسوله أما بعد فأعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم فاقصص القصص لعلهم يتفكرون وقال الله تعالى إن الذين يستكبرون عن عبادتي سيدخلون جهنم داخرين وقال الله تعالى وإذا سألك عبادي عني فإني قريب أجيب دعوة الداعي إذا دعان فليستجيبوا لي وليؤمنوا بي لعلهم يرشدون وعن ابن عمر رضي الله عنهما عن النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم قال خرج ثلاثة يمشون فأصابهم المطر فدخلوا في غار في جبل فانحطت عليهم صخرة قال فقال بعضهم لبعض ادعوا الله بأفضل عمل عملتموه فقال أحدهم اللهم إني كان لي أبوان شيخان كبيران فكنت أخرج فأرعى ثم أجيء فأحلبه إلى آخر الحديث صدق الله العظيم وصدق رسوله النبي الكريم ونحن على ذلك لمن الشاهدين والشاكرين والحمد لله رب العالمين إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما اللهم صل على سيدنا ونبينا ومولانا محمد وبارك على سيدنا ونبينا ومولانا محمد رب اشرح لي صدري ويسر لي أمري واحلل عقدة من لساني يفقه قولي رب زدني علما My dear respected brothers, elders, brothers and sisters listening at home, Alhamdulillah, we have gone through many special days, special weeks and special months. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave some of us the means and the ability to travel for Hajj. Some of them have already returned. Some of our brothers, some of our family members, friends are still there. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to accept their Hajj and all the ibadat that they have carried out and all the dua they have made. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to accept their ibadat and accept their dua. And those who are not able to go, any ibadat that they have done whilst they were at home, qurbani, etc. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to accept the qurbani and accept our ibadat as well. The days of Hajj, the days of Dhul-Hijjah, is linked to Hazrat Ibrahim alayhi salam, Hazrat Ismail alayhi salam. We cannot speak about Hajj, we cannot speak about qurbani without discussing the life of Ibrahim alayhi salam and Hazrat Ismail alayhi salam. We have to discuss their lives. Only then we will understand the concept of Hajj, of qurbani. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has discussed the life of these individuals in the Quran in different places. Likewise, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has a method. In many parts of the Quran, He mentions the stories of previous prophets, previous nations, many pious individuals, males, females, and the purpose of all the stories in the Quran, he says, فَقْصُصِ الْقَصَصَ لَعَلَّهُمْ يَتَفَكَّرُونَ The reason why he brings the stories in the Quran is not just to entertain us, it's not just for us to enjoy ourselves. لَعَلَّهُمْ يَتَفَكَّرُونَ The reason why the stories are mentioned in the Quran is so that we may take lessons from them. We may understand that those nations who came before us, if they accepted the message of their respected prophets, what happened to them? How successful they were? And those who rejected their message, what happened to them? What is going to happen to them in the future?
So this is the lesson. Likewise, Nabi alayhi salatu wasalam, in his ahadith, he also has a system and a method to strengthen our iman. He has a method for us to understand the purpose of our creation. Nabi alayhi salatu wasalam also, in many, many ahadith, has brought the stories of previous nations, stories of previous prophets, so that the sahaba, so that the ummah that come after them, take lessons from these stories, so that they don't fall in the same path and the same hole of failure. So they may realize that, okay, this is the path that we need to take. So they may realize that this is what we need to do in our lives for us to be successful in this world, for us to gain the pleasure and the happiness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the hereafter. One of the incident, one of the story Nabi alayhi salatu wasalam mentions, recorded in Sahih Bukhari and Sahih Muslim, is about three individuals of Banu Israel. Now these three individuals of Banu Israel, they were walking, and all of a sudden there was a heavy rain. There was a heavy rain. And the only shelter that they had nearby was to climb into a cave of a mountain. So the three individuals ended up in this cave to save themselves from this heavy rain, thinking that once the rain stops, we may leave and return home. When they were inside the cave, the decree of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, there was a rock which rolled down to the mouth and the entrance of this cave, and he blocked the entrance. So these three individuals are trapped and stuck inside the cave, and the rock is outside, and they have no way to get out. There is no exit. In those days, they didn't have the technology that we have nowadays, that we just press one button and we call somebody outside. So these three individuals inside the cave, they thought to themselves that, what can we do? They did a mashura within each other. And how can we remove this rock? We don't have the physical strength to remove this rock. We don't have any contact to anybody outside. We don't have any tools. We don't have anything. So what should we do? So the mashura they came up to was that we make dua to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We make dua to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And in our dua, we will mention any one good amal that we have done according to our knowledge, which was done only for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. There was no other intention when we did that amal. It was only for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So we will mention that amal in our dua. And through that, the means of that and the wasila of that amal and that deed, we hope that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will help us. So these three individuals lifted their hands. So Nabi alayhi salatu wasalam says that one of them, in his dua, he says that, oh Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, I had a very old parents. My parents who have gone old. And it was my daily habit that I would go out farming, looking after the animals, milk them, etc. When I would return home later in the afternoon or in the evening, the milk that I have gathered, I would present it to my parents first. Even though I had family members, I had my wife, I had my children, slave, and etc. But I didn't, I kept them second. I gave my parents a priority. So every day I would do this. I would, do the service of my parents when I returned from work. The first thing was to go to my parents and feed them the milk. So this was my daily habit. Once it happened that I got delayed of returning home. When I returned home, I found out that my parents have fallen asleep. And I already had this habit, and this was my, part of me, that I would serve my parents first. So I waited near them, waiting for them to wake up. I waited and I waited and I waited until it was morning, tala al-fajr, until it was morning time. I disliked to wake them up, to disturb them. So I stood there waiting until it was morning. When they woke up, I fed them the milk, then I fed my family members. So he says that, oh Allah, if I did this amal only for your sake, if the ghaa wajhi rabbik, only for your sake, then remove this rock, remove this difficulty. So Nabi alayhi salatu wasalam says that the rock slightly moved, that they were able to see some light into the cave. However, it wasn't enough for them to come out. Then the second individual in his dua, he mentions that, oh Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, there was a cousin sister of mine. I had so much love for her. I would always want to become close to her, but she would always refuse. However, once there was a drought and she fell into a difficult situation where she had to turn to me for some financial help. So I said to her, okay, I will gather some dinar and I will gather some wealth on the condition that you allow me to fulfill my desire with you. You allow me to come close to you. She was in a desperate situation, so she said, okay, she agreed. So when I gathered the wealth, she came, and according to the condition, I was in control of her, like a husband is with his wife. To that moment where a husband normally doesn't, he's not able to leave, he's not able to move himself. I was in that much of the control. But then she said, ittaqillah, fear of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, fear of Allah, what are you doing now? So even though I was in that situation where there was nothing to stop me, and there was no barrier, nothing, she only took your name and I moved back and I let her go. So he said that, oh Allah, if I did this only for your sake, remove this difficulty, remove this rock. Nabi alayhi salatu wasalam says that this dua was also accepted and the rock was slightly moved. But they were not able to come out yet. The third individual, he makes dua to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that, oh Allah, I had a business. There was an individual who used to work for me. When it was time for him to take his wages, he refused and he left. He was separating, he left. The wages that I was supposed to give him, I invested it into some animals and flocks of animals. Later on, he came back to me and he said to me that, can I have my wage? Only a few dinars, whatever the small amount was. So I took this worker of mine to a valley where he was full of animals, full of shepherds. So I said to him, here, that's your wage. So he said to me that, I only asked for a wage. My wage was only a small amount. You're not taking any mockery out of me. So I replied to him that the wage that you left behind, I invested it, and this is the outcome of it. So all of this is yours. Even though he didn't need to do that, I didn't need to do that, but I did it for for your sake only. So he said that, oh Allah, if I did this amal only for your sake, remove this difficulty. So Nabi alayhi salatu wasalam says that this third individual, the third person's dua was also accepted. The rock slightly moved more and they were able to come out. This is the hadith narrated by Nabi alayhi salatu wasalam, recorded in Sahih Bukhari and Sahih Muslim. However, there are so many lessons that we can take from this hadith. One of them is the three individuals gave an example of how we should treat our family members, how we should be with the opposite gender, how we should deal with our workers, with our workmates, our colleagues, with our employees. First one, he gave us a very beautiful example how to treat your parents. Birrul walidain. This is one of the first lessons that we need to take. The question I would like to ask all of us here, everybody who can hear this, how is our friendship, how is our connection with our parents, with our mothers and fathers if they are alive? How do we treat them? What is our connection with our mothers and fathers? What do we do when we go home? What do we do in their presence? What do we do when they tell us to do something? How do we respond? How do we react? Who do we give priorities to? Do we give priorities to our parents or do we give priorities to our friends? Do we give priorities to our phones when we are in their presence or do we talk to them and we give them attention? Our parents have suffered so much. They have done so much for us. But never ever did they say, can I have something in return? When we were young, when you were still a baby, they looked after us, they fed us, They changed us. Every time we cried, they were there to answer our cry. They were able to, they carried out every, the necessities of ours. We grew up. Even then, they looked after us. Even now, we become, teenagers. They're still looking after us. They're still taking care of us. They're still cooking food for us. They're still giving us shelter above our heads. But how are we treating our parents? What are we doing in return? Are we looking after them? Are we taking care of them? Are we answering them back? What is our treatment with our parents? Nabi alayhi salatu wasalam, he mentions, Akbarul Kabair, the biggest of the great sins. A sin is also already a great sin. But out of all those sins, the greatest sin. And he says one of them is to make partnership with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And the second one is disobedience to the parent. Remember, friends come and go. When we were in reception, when we were in primary, when we were in secondary, we had friends, many friends. But not all of them are still with us. So friends come and go. You can exchange friends. You can replace a friend. But you can never ever replace your mother and a father. Remember that. So how are we treating our parents? If we want Jannat, if we want prosperity, if you want barakat in our business, if you want barakat in our lives, treat your parents with good. If you're finding difficulties in your lives, any sort of difficulties, financial difficulties, family issues, whatever, go to the mother of your the feet of your mother and ask her for the du'as. Just treat her good. By treating her good, automatically the du'as will come for us. We don't need to request for the du'a actually. If we treat our parents with goodness, when they wake up in the middle of the night, they will remember us. They will make du'as for us. So this is one lesson that we need to take. The treatment with our parents. The second lesson that we need to take is the second individual who fell in love with his cousin sister. Now, we sometimes fall in this situation. Our young ones, we fall in this situation many times in our schools, our workplaces. And sometimes nowadays it even happens even if you're married. Because, we like to scan around too much. We like to search and follow too many other people. So, if we are in that situation, what did we do? What are we doing? That individual was, ready to commit the sin of fulfilling his desires with his cousin sister. But only she took the name of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and he stopped. What do we need to do? Anytime that we fall in a situation of committing a zina, we need to remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is always watching me. We need to remember that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is going to take account of me one day. He is going to ask me every moment of my life. We need to remember this question. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is alim. He knows every single thing. He knows what goes into our hearts and crosses our minds. The third individual gave an example of how to treat our workers. It happens sometimes, people work for us, we mistreat them. Or sometimes we make an agreement with some builder and we tell him, okay, I need work A, B, C done. And he comes with an agreement of this much payment and etc. But when he comes, what do with him? We give him the job C, B, no, D, E, F as well. Even though he wasn't agreed, but we're only going to pay him for A, B, C. We're not going to pay him for D, E, F. Is this how we should be treating our builders and our workers? No. We need to be honest with our workers as well. Every work they do, we need to make sure that we pay them. We will be questioned about that. That this individual worked for you. How did you treat him? Did you pay him on time, etc.? So this is the third lesson that we need to take. Another lesson, a very important lesson, there are so many other lessons. One important lesson we need to take before I finish is the power of dua. The power of dua. These three individuals were trapped in the cave. There was nothing else to take them out. They made dua to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala removed that rock and removed that difficulty. If you look around the world, the whole of the Muslim world, the Muslim ummah, there's a rock before us. There are enemies everywhere where they are plotting against us. There are Muslim brothers and sisters of ours. You know, they are in trouble. The Muslim brothers of Kashmir. Imagine the difficulty that they're going through. They don't even know that if they're going to be performing that Jum'ah Salah today. They don't even know that. Their life is at risk. Poverty, starvation, murder, rape, so many things. Everybody knows. So what we need to do is, we need to make du'as for them. We need to make du'as for them.
أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أشهد أن محمدا رسول الله أشهد أن محمدا رسول الله حي على الصلاة حي على الفلاح الله أكبر الله أكبر لا
Off of the whole Muslim world, the Muslim brothers and sisters, we need to do istighfar. Daily, nastaghfirullah, nastaghfirullah, 300 times, 300 times, 3,000 times, whatever is possible for us, we need to do that. And in this manner, inshallah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will make it easy for everyone and will remove all the difficulties. Ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to give us the ability to.
Thank you.
الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أشهد أن محمدا رسول الله أشهد أن محمدا رسول الله حي على الصلاة
الحمد لله العلي الأعلى الذي خلق فسوى وقدر فهدى بسط لنا الأرض ورفع السماوات العلى سبحانه ما أعظم شانه وأكرم مكانه يعلم ما فوق العرش وما تحت الثرى وإن تجهر بالقول فإنه يعلم السر وأخفى أشهد أنه لا إله إلا هو له الأسماء الحسنى وأشهد أن سيدنا ومولانا محمدًا عبده ورسوله صاحب المقام المعلى دنا فتدلى فكان قاب قوسين أو أدنى فأوحى ربه إليه ما أوحى ما كذب الفؤاد ما رأى صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وصحبه أصحاب الدرجات العلى وبعد فيا أيها الإنسان ما غرك بربك الكريم الذي خلق فسوى وعدل وركب في أي صورة ما شاء وألهم النفوس الفجور والتقوى وسهل لك الطريق إلى الجنات العلى فبعث أنبياء ورسلا مبشرين ومنذرين بالمعجزات والآيات العلى وأنزل على نبينا سيد الأنبياء القرآن تذكرة لمن يخشى عباد الله تذكروا نعم الله وتفكروا في خلق الله ولازم التقوى فمن خاف مقام ربه ونهى النفس فإن الجنة له المأوى ألا إن هذا الشهر المبارك قد استأذن منكم الرحيل وما بقي منه إلا قليل وبرحمته ترحل السنة وتأتي عليكم سنة جديدة أخرى فودعوها بصالح الأعمال واستقبلوها بالحسنى هل منكم من اجتهد في هذه السنة الذاهبة في العبادات والطاعات ونهى النفس عن الهوى؟ هل منكم من استغفر ربه في كل آن وحاسب نفسه في كل زمان ونفعت له الذكرى؟ فطوبى لمن شهدت له هذه السنة عند ربه بالتقوى وويل ثم ويل لمن ضيع أيام السنة وشهورها وأنهمك في قضاء حاجات النفوس وفجورها فضل وغوى يا أيها الناس مضى ما مضى فاتركوا فيما يأتي الدعوة واستغفروا الله مما مضى واغتنموا شبابكم قبل هرمكم وحياتكم قبل موتكم وعافيتكم قبل مرضكم وغناءكم قبل فقركم وليحاسب كل امرئ نفسه إذا أصبح وأمسى وتفكروا فيما يمر عليكم عند الموت وبعده من الكروب والأهوال الكبرى كيف بكم إذا ألقي عليكم التراب وولى عنكم كل بعيد وأدنى فبقيتم في بيت الوحشة
متفرددين متحيرين متحسرين باكين على ما صدر وما مضى، وابتليتم بسؤال النكيرين والضغطة التي تتكسر منها عظام الثقلين، وأحاطت بكم الظلمة والوحشة، فإن القبر أول منزل من منازل الآخرة، فمن نجا من شدائده فسنيسر اليسرى، ومن ابتلي فيه بالمحنة فما بعده إلا العسرى. الله الله عباد الله، اتقوا الله واجتنبوا الهوى، وقولوا من صميم الفؤاد وخلوص لسان الذكرى: اللهم إنا عبادك العصاة، فارحمنا وعافنا ووفقنا لما تحب وترضى. أعوذ بالله السميع العليم من الشيطان الرجيم. طه: ما أنزلنا عليك القرآن لتشقى إلا تذكرة لمن يخشى، تنزيلا ممن خلق الأرض والسماوات العلى، الرحمن على العرش استوى، له ما في السماوات وما في الأرض وما بينهما وما تحت الثرى. الحمد لله، نستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا، من يهدي الله فلا مضل له، ومن يضلله فلا هادي له، ونشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، ونشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله، أرسله بالحق بشيرا ونذيرا بين يدي الساعة. من يطيع الله ورسوله فقد رشد، ومن يعصيهما فإنه لا يضر إلا نفسه ولا يضر الله شيئا. أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي: يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما. اللهم صل على محمد عبدك ورسولك، وصل على المؤمنين والمؤمنات والمسلمين والمسلمات، وبارك على محمد وأزواجه وذريته. قال النبي صلى الله عليه وآله وسلم: أرحم أمتي بأمتي أبو بكر، وأشدهم في أمر الله عمر، وأصدقهم حياء عثمان، وأقضاهم علي، وفاطمة سيدة نساء أهل الجنة، والحسن والحسين سيدا شباب أهل الجنة، وحمزة أسد الله وأسد رسوله رضوان الله تعالى عليهم أجمعين. اللهم اغفر للعباس وولده مغفرة ظاهرة وباطنة لا تغادر ذنبا. الله الله في أصحابي لا تتخذوهم غرضا من بعدي، فمن أحبهم فبحبي أحبهم، ومن أبغضهم فببغي أبغضهم، وخير أمتي قرني ثم الذين يلونهم ثم الذين يلونهم. إن الله يأمر بالعدل والإحسان وإيتاء ذي القربى وينهى عن الفحشاء والمنكر والبغي يعظكم لعلكم تذكرون. فاذكروني يذكركم واشكروني ولا تكفرون. All the brothers are kindly requested to complete the rows. There's many spaces on the right side of the Jamaat Khana, and the spaces in the downstairs Jamaat Khana as well. The brothers who are upstairs kindly requested to complete the Jamaat Khana downstairs first. And fill in the gaps, make sure standing shoulder to shoulder.
Allahu Akbar. الحمد لله رب العالمين، الرحمن الرحيم، مالك يوم الدين، إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين، اهدنا الصراط المستقيم، صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين. والضحى والليل إذا سجى، ما ودعك ربك وما قلى، وللآخرة خير لك من الأولى، ولسوف يعطيك ربك فترضى. ألم يجدك يتيما فآوى، ووجدك ضالا فهدى،
وجدك عائلا فأغنى فأما اليتيم فلا تقهر وأما السائل فلا تنهر وأما بنعمة ربك فحدث. الله أكبر. سمع الله لمن حمده. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الحمد لله رب العالمين الرحمن الرحيم مالك يوم الدين إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين. ألم نشرح لك صدرك ووضعنا عنك وزرك الذي أنقض ظهرك ورفعنا لك ذكرك فإن مع العسر يسرا إن مع العسر يسرا فإذا فرغت فانصب وإلى ربك فارغب. الله أكبر. سمع الله لمن حمده. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله.
All the brothers once again are kindly reminded to make dua for all the Muslim brothers and sisters around the world, especially those Muslim brothers and sisters, innocent children, women, old, elderly, the suffering in Kashmir on the hands of the oppressors. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to assist them, to help them to remove the oppression. We do not look towards our sins. We look at the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. In the hadith mentioned in the bayan, all the three individuals played a role for the rock to be removed. For our rock, for our barriers, for the oppression in this day and age, for it to be removed, every single Muslim has to turn to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It doesn't matter how many sins that we have committed, it doesn't matter how sinful we are. We look towards the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will answer our call and will assist us as well. Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Subhanallah wa bihamdihi. Subhanak Allahumma wa bihamdika. Nashhadu an la ilaha illa anta nastaghfiruka wa natubu ilayk. Subhanallah wa bihamdihi adada khalqihi wa ridha nafsihi wa zinata arshihi wa midada kalimatihi. Subhanallah wa bihamdihi. Subhanallah al-Azim. Ya Adim al-Sultan, Ya Qadim al-Ihsan, salli ala Muhammad wa ala ali Muhammad wa barik wa sallim. Allahumma salli ala Muhammad abdika wa rasulik wa salli ala al-mu'minin wa minatul muslimin wa muslimat. اللهم صل على محمد كلما ذكر وذاكرون وصل على محمد كلما غفل عن ذكر الغافلون ربنا ظلمنا أنفسنا ربنا ظلمنا أنفسنا ربنا ظلمنا أنفسنا وإن لم تغفر لنا وترحمنا لنكونن من الخاسرين لا إله إلا أنت سبحانك إنا كنا من الظالمين لا إله إلا أنت سبحانك إنا كنا من الظالمين نستغفر الله نستغفر الله نستغفر الله العظيم لا إله إلا هو الحي القيوم نتوب إليه اللهم اهدنا فيمن هديت وعافنا فيمن عافيت وتولنا فيمن توليت وبارك لنا فيما أعطيت وقنا شر ما قضيت فإنك تقضي ولا يقضى عليك إنه لا يذل من واليت ولا يعز من عديت تبارك ربنا وتعاليك نستغفرك ونتوب إليك نستغفرك ونتوب إليك وصلى الله على النبي الكريم اللهم انصر الإسلام والمسلمين اللهم أعز الإسلام والمسلمين اللهم انصر الإسلام وأهله واخذل الباطل وجنده اللهم انصر إخواننا المسلمين المستضعفين في كل مكان اللهم انصرهم في كل مكان اللهم انصرهم في فلسطين اللهم انصرهم في كشمير اللهم انصرهم في الهند اللهم انصرهم في كل مكان اللهم انصرهم ولا تنصر عليهم اللهم أعينهم ولا تعين عليهم اللهم كر لهم ولا تنكر عليهم اللهم احقن دماء المسلمين اللهم فرج كرب المسلمين اللهم من أراد بالإسلام والمسلمين خيرا فوفق لكل خير ومن أراد به غير ذلك فخذ أخذ عزيز مقتدر واجعله عبرة لمن يعتبر اللهم احفظنا واحفظهم من بين يديهم ومن خلفهم وعن أيمانهم وعن شمائلهم يا أرحم الراحمين يا غياث المستغيثين ربنا آتنا في الدنيا حسنة وفي الآخرة حسنة وقنا عذاب النار ربنا لا تجعلنا فتنة للقوم الظالمين ونجنا برحمتك من القوم الكافرين إنك فيناك المستهزئين إنك فيناك المستهزئين إنك فيناك المستهزئين اللهم إنا نسألك من خير ما سألك نبيك سيدنا محمد صلى الله عليه وآله وسلم ونعوذ بك من شر ما استعاذ منه نبيك سيدنا محمد صلى الله عليه وآله وسلم أنت المستعان وعليك البلاغ ولا حول ولا قوة إلا بالله العلي العظيم لا حول ولا قوة إلا بالله لا ملجأ ولا منجأ منك إلا إليك لا حول ولا قوة إلا بالله لا ملجأ ولا منجأ منك إلا إليك ربنا تقبل منا إنك أنت السميع العليم وتب علينا إنك أنت التواب الرحيم وصلى الله تعالى على خير خلقه محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين سبحان ربك رب العزة عما يصفون وسلام على المرسلين والحمد لله رب العالمين برحمتك يا أرحم الراحمين.